Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the parish of All Saints Harrow Weald. We're part of the Diocese of London in the Church of England. I'm John Barker, I'm the vicar of the parish. We are live streaming worship, sometimes in church, and today we're in the study of the vicarage. Our worship today will be morning prayer at the said morning office from Common Worship, the standard order of service that we use in the Church of England. And the worship will begin at around 10:30 UK time. I invite you to join us and worship with us this morning. And as we prepare for worship, we have the choir of the parish of St Martin in the Fields in central London, and they're singing Glorious Things of Thee Are Spoken. Glorious things of thee are spoken, Zion, city of our Lord. Beautiful and inspiring song as we prepare for worship this morning. It's a Tuesday morning in England. I don't know what time of day it is wherever you are as you worship with us, but whatever time it is, for me, it's always a good time to worship God. And so let us worship God with morning prayer from Common Worship. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Your faithful servants bless you. They make known the glory of your kingdom. Our opening prayer. Blessed are you, sovereign God, ruler and judge of all. To you be praise and glory forever. In the darkness of this age that is passing away, may the light of your presence, which the saints enjoy, surround our steps as we journey on. May we reflect your glory this day and so be made ready to see your face in the heavenly city, where night shall be no more. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. Let's keep silence for a moment and commend to God all that will be, all that may be during this new day. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. Our morning psalm, the first verses of Psalm 106, with the refrain, "The Lord remembered his covenant." Alleluia. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is gracious. For his faithfulness endures forever. Who can express the mighty acts of the Lord, or show forth all his praise? Blessed are those who observe what is right, and always do what is just. Remember me, O Lord, in the favour you bear for your people. Visit me in the day of your salvation, that I may see the prosperity of your chosen and rejoice in the gladness of your people and exult with your inheritance. The Lord remembered his covenant. Holy God, when our memories blot out your kindness and we ignore your patient love, remember us, remake us, and give to us poor sinners the rich inheritance of Jesus Christ our Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Our Old Testament canticle. Spirit of God, teach us your ways, that we may walk in the paths of peace. Come, let us go up to the mountain of God, to the house of the God of Jacob, that God may teach us his ways, and that we may walk in his paths. For the law shall go out from Zion, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. God shall judge between the nations and shall mediate for many peoples. They shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war any more. O people of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Spirit of God, teach us your ways, that we may walk in the paths of peace. Our New Testament reading is taken from the letter of St. Paul to the church in Philippi, verses from the first chapter. Paul writes, I want you to know, beloved, that what has happened to me has actually helped to spread the gospel, so that it has become known throughout the whole Imperial Guard and to everyone else that my imprisonment is for Christ. And most of the brothers and sisters, having been made confident in the Lord by my imprisonment, dare to speak the word with greater boldness and without fear. Some proclaim Christ from envy and rivalry, but others from goodwill. These proclaim Christ out of love, knowing that I've been put here for the defence of the gospel. The others proclaim Christ out of selfish ambition, not sincerely, but intending to increase my suffering in my imprisonment. What does it matter? Just this, that Christ is proclaimed in every way, whether out of false motives or true, and in that I rejoice. Yes, and I will continue to rejoice, for I know that through your prayers and the help of the Spirit of Jesus Christ, this will result in my deliverance. It is my eager expectation and hope that I will not be put to shame in any way, but that by my speaking with all boldness, Christ will be exalted now, as always in my body, whether by life or death. For to me, living is Christ and dying is gain. If I am to live in the flesh, that means fruitful labour for me, and I do not know which I prefer. I am hard pressed between the two. My desire is to depart and be with Christ, for that is far better. But to remain in the flesh is more necessary for you. Since I am convinced of this, I know that I will remain and continue with all of you for your progress and joy in faith, so that I may share abundantly in your boasting in Christ Jesus when I come to you again. Only live your life in a manner worthy of the gospel of Christ, so that when I come and see you or am absent and hear about you, I will know that you are standing firm in one spirit, striving side by side with one mind for the faith of the gospel, and are in no way intimidated by your opponents. For them this is evidence of their destruction, but of your salvation, and this is God's doing. For he has graciously granted you the privilege not only of believing in Christ, but of suffering for him as well, since you are having the same struggle that you saw I had and now hear that I still have. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Some wonderful words written by Paul, which have many and all positive examples for us. We can see Paul confirming that by God's grace, good comes from bad. He was in prison, but that provided a new opportunity to have time to spend with those who were his jailers and the fellow inmates and convince them of the grace of God and the blessings that can be received through Christ. And then he warned us to be careful about the reasons why we profess to be Christian. And he said that sometimes it's for a God-given reason and sometimes it's for vanity or for self-gain. Very interestingly, he said, it actually doesn't matter what the purpose is, as long as God's will is done. But of course, the greater reward is if we're doing it for God, not for ourselves. And then finally, he commends us to live our lives in a manner worthy of the gospel of Christ. And he points out the difficulties he was facing as a prisoner. He'd been mocked, he'd been challenged, he'd been persecuted, he'd been beaten. He knew that the people of the Church of Philippi were facing similar challenges. We face challenges right now. We don't know where we're going with coronavirus. We don't know how we will be able to worship God in these coming weeks. Will we still be allowed to meet in church? Will we be back to only online worship? We do not know. We have all sorts of uncertainties and anxieties. And Paul commends us that whatever the circumstances in our lives, to remember the fundamental challenge to live our lives in a manner worthy of the gospel of Christ. And so I pray that all of us, as we face up to uncertainty, may day by day live our lives in a manner which is worthy of the gospel of Christ. Amen. Open my eyes, O Lord, that I may see the wonders of your law. Open my eyes, O Lord, that I may see the wonders of your law. Lead me in the path of your commandments, that I may see the wonders of your law. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Open my eyes, O Lord, that I may see the wonders of your law. Our New Testament canticle, the Benedictus. In your tender compassion, O God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, God promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hand of all that hate us, to show mercy to our ancestors, and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath God swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight, all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of all their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. In your tender compassion, O God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us. Let us pray. Dear loving Heavenly Father, as we worship you this morning, we pray that we may live our lives in a way that is worthy of the gospel of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Father, we live in desperately uncertain times, and anxiety and a fear of the unknown affect us all, however great and worthy our faith. And so we pray that you will give us peace in our hearts and the reassurance of the presence of your Holy Spirit surrounding us and guiding us along the way, so that however great our fears and uncertainties, however powerful our anxieties, we may continue to show your light wherever we are and whoever we are with. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we commend to you all that will be, wherever we are living and whatever the situation in our home countries. May we go step by step, day by day with you, in faith, knowing that we cannot control what will be, but we can be careful for ourselves and caring for others. May we live our lives thinking always about your will for us and the needs and cares for others. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And now we turn to our personal prayers, remembering those who we know and love who particularly need the reassurance of your peace surrounding them at this time. We pray for those who we know and love who are affected by coronavirus or who are needing to take tests to see if they and their family members have the virus. We pray for those who wait anxiously for tests for different medical reasons. May your peace be with them. Guard and reassure them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And finally, in these prayers, we remember those who we have known and loved who are no longer with us. We thank you for the love they shared with us and for the example that they gave to us. May their rest with you be eternal, Lord. And may we show in the way that we live our lives that we have learned from their example. And so we commend ourselves and all for whom we pray to the mercy and protection of God. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Our colleague for this day. O God, for as much as without you we are not able to please you, mercifully grant that your Holy Spirit may in all things direct and rule our hearts. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil and keep us in eternal life. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. And now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Thank you for joining us for worship again this morning, wherever you are. I pray that for all of us, this day may be a happy day, that we may keep safe in this day, and that we may be able to serve the Lord wherever we are and whatever our circumstances. If you'd like to worship with us tomorrow, you can do that either in church, we'll be in All Saints, for a Eucharistic service. That will be at 11:30 UK time. And if you can't physically make it to All Saints, then you can join us either live via Facebook, or the service will be uploaded later onto YouTube. But that's tomorrow. Let's not waste today. May you be happy, may you be healthy, and may God bless you all. We'll finish as we started with a beautiful hymn, a rousing hymn from the choir of St. Martin in the Fields. Thou whose almighty word chaos and darkness heard and took their flight.